questions. In the previous video we had seen about the Thevenin's theorem statement and the problems. Next we'll go for Norton's theorem. So your Norton's theorem is same like that of your Thevenin's theorem. So instead of open circuiting your load voltage, we are going to short circuit the load resistance there. And the current which is going to flow through the load resistance is going to be called as a short circuit current. So we say that your Norton's theorem states that a linear two terminal network can be replaced by a single equivalent current source IN in parallel with your resistance RN, where IN is going to be called as the short circuit current through the terminals and RN is going to be called as the equivalent Thevenin's resistance here at the terminals when the independent sources are going to be turned off. So same procedure as that of your Thevenin's theorem. Only thing is, here in this case, instead of a load terminals open circuiting it, we are going to short circuit the load terminals there. So here your steps, what you are going to do is, first is short circuit the load resistance. So by short circuiting the load resistance, we are going to measure the short circuit current. Then afterwards, by measuring the short circuit current, that current we call it as ISC or IN. Then open circuit. So in this case, to find out your load resistance, your Thevenin's resistance, what we are going to do is open circuit your current sources, short circuit your voltage sources, and the load resistance, if there is going to be any, remove the load resistance or open the load resistance then. Then calculate your open circuit resistance. So that is called as your Thevenin's resistance or RTH or RN. Next is, we are going to redraw the circuit, your equivalent circuit. You know that always your current source should be in parallel with your resistance. So your current source is nothing but your ISC or IN, and your resistance is going to be your RTH or your RN in parallel with the current source there. So we will get the equivalent resistance. Now we have to find out what is going to be the current that is going to flow through your load resistance IL. So to find out the current through your load resistance IL, through the load resistance IL, we are going to apply a current divider rule. We know the total current. Total current is nothing but your IN into opposite resistance is going to be your RN divided by your total resistance is going to be RN plus RL. So here in this case, your proof of your Thevenin's theorem is going to be, we are going to take a circuit here. Your RL is going to be the load resistance. So what you are going to do is, to find out your ISC current, remove the load resistance RL, short circuit the load resistance there. Once you short circuit it, you are going to have a circuit like this. So now we are going to apply your KCL. So in this case, if I am going to apply, so this is going to be your I1, this is going to be your ISC. So to find out your ISC or I2, we can say that this is your I2 current. So here in this case, I can take it as your I2 current also there. So your total current is equivalent to total resistance. If I want to find out your total resistance is, this voltage source will be shorted. If this is going to be shorted, these two are going to be in series. So we write it as RI plus R1. So here in this case, it will be a short circuit one like this. So RI plus R1 in parallel with your, like this, if I am going to come from here. So suppose our diagram is going to be from here, if I am going to see your RTH, you are going to have this to be your voltage source. So your circuit will be like this. So this is your R1. This is going to be your RI. So here you are going to have your R2. So here you are going to have your R3. And this is going to be your RTH. So here in this case, we are going to have your R2 and R3 are going to be, this circuit, if I see, R2 plus R3 is going to be in parallel, and here that parallel resistance is going to be equivalent to this series resistance. So total resistance is going to be like this. So a circuit is going to be, this is your E voltage and your total resistance is going to be R. So now we are going to find out what is going to be our ISC. So I1 is equivalent to E by R. So now the Norton's equivalent circuit, to find out the Norton's current, your I2 or ISC, here in this case your total current is going to be your I1 into opposite resistance is going to be R2 divided by total resistance is R2 plus R3. So we know that your I1 is nothing but your current is nothing but your E by R1 plus RI plus R2 parallel R3 into R2 by R2 plus R3. So if we simplify, this is the equation what we will be getting in. So next is, Here we are going to find to determine the internal resistance. So internal resistance is remove the load resistance. You can see that Ra plus R1 is in parallel. That is in, so this is in series. So here in this case, these two resistors are in series. And then this is in parallel. So we write it as your R1 plus Ri in parallel with R2. That is in series with your R3. So this is your equivalent resistance what we are going to get. Now your equivalent circuit is going to be In in parallel with Rn in parallel with RL. So now to find out your IL, you know the total current In into opposite resistance is going to be Rn divided by total resistance is Rn plus RL. This is your current through your load resistance there. So find the Norton's equivalent for the circuit of figure below. So here in this case, this is your current source here. So now what we are going to do is your short circuit, the load resistance should be short circuited. So when you short circuited, you are going to have, there is going to be no current flowing through this circuit. So I can eliminate this resistance there. And if I am going to assume that this is the current I and here this is your ISC. So sum of incoming currents is going to be 3 amps. Outgoing current is I plus ISC. What is I? The voltage at this point is going to be VA. So VA minus 24 plus 2 minus is going to be minus 24 divided by 4. So here plus ISC. So we know that your VA voltage is going to be, anyway this VA is going to be connected. See this, this is all going to be same. That is nothing but to the ground voltage. So we know that VA is going to be 0. When VA is going to be 0, then ISC is equivalent to 9 amps. So here now RTH, to find out your RTH, the voltage source should be shorted, current source should be open circuited. That means 4 and 12 are going to be in parallel. So in that case, your RTH is equivalent to 12 into 4 divided by 12 plus 4, that is 3 ohms. So your Thevenin's equivalent current is going to be a 9 amps in parallel with your 3 ohms resistor there. Thank you.